Hey everyone, it's Macy from Good Faith Energy, answering an important question. What happens if your home battery drains to zero? Does your home battery work just like your phone battery? You know, waiting until the last minute to use up every bit of power until there's nothing left? Here's the deal. I had our engineers break this down to more simple terms for you and I. Batteries are made up of cells, and when they get really low, those cells start to strain. Imagine if you're running a marathon without enough water. Not fun, right? It's the same for your battery. Running a battery down too low can actually wear it out faster over time. That means you might need to replace it sooner, and that's something we all want to avoid. So what's the minimum battery percentage that you should let your home battery reach? Ideally, you should not let it drain below 10%. If you're off-grid, it's best to turn off your house when the battery hits 10% to save energy while waiting for the sun to come back out. When your battery goes below 10%, it's like running on fumes. Not ideal, not fun. Here's how you do it. Turn off your main disconnect on the breaker panel, but keep the battery system running. It'll start charging back on its own once the sun is back out the next day. You can then turn your home power back on and use it carefully until the solar charge improves or the grid is restored. We'd all love to be 100% energy independent, but during rough weather, you might need to rely on the grid temporarily while your battery gets some needed R&R. Now, let's say you didn't manage to keep it above 10%. Do you need us to come out and fix it? If you handle those low charge levels wisely, no service trip is needed. But if your battery drains all the way to zero, a service trip might be needed or required. You have to wait for the power grid to come back on, and in some cases, the system can revive itself when solar power returns. But other times, you might need a generator or another compatible battery to get things going again. It all depends on the system. So will your battery start charging on its own if it does hit 0%? Some systems, like the Enphase with the IQ8 Plus, a Franklin, or a Solark, can restart on their own. Others can't. Tesla batteries have a 12V jumpstart port, but if they can't supply at least 10 minutes of power to activate the solar inverters, you're out of luck. We recommend having no load on the system while attempting a 12V jumpstart. Finally, can you run lithium-ion batteries to zero? Technically, doing so would ruin them. But don't worry, your battery's management software will shut down the system well before the battery is truly at zero. What shows as 0% on your monitoring app isn't actually completely depleted battery. So remember, keeping your battery above 10% isn't just good practice, it's key to keeping your system healthy and ready to power your home when you need it most. For all of your home energy needs, call us at this number below or click the link to fill out a free, no-hassle quote. And until next week, I'm Macy with Good Faith Energy. Stay charged.